to be turning up.
You already know. You already know.
She be turning up. I know, sis.
Her and Lorena? Oh, God. When they get together.
It's weird for me. You blurry. Go to the other side.
Oh, my gosh. Why does this keep happening?
I don't know why. If you crystal clear and spot, you want to go to the blurry side.
Is this clear?
Nah, it ain't clear like that.
Let me go back this way.
Let's see if it's getting better. I mean, it's less blurry there. Yes, don't worry about all that. Yo, Shanti, you're beautiful. I tell you, everybody's crush. I told you everything you needed to hear. The baby airs.
Wait, let me check. Let me check on Wi-Fi real quick. Hold on.
Oh, my God. You look amazing.
And let me tell you, if Optimum Online is watching, y'all are trash, and I'm changing my service.
Well, you look clear right now. You're perfect. Don't move. So if the dog bark, don't go over there.
It's one right here.
Come on. I go back. Shafi, I go back. When all this Murder in G-Unit shit started, right? Did you feel like you was caught up in this shit?
I definitely, definitely felt like, what do you call that? The innocent bystander. You know how you get sniped by a stray bullet? I definitely felt like I had nothing to do with it, but what do they call it? Guilty by association. And it's crazy because at the time, my ex was from Queens. And when I told him everything I was doing, he was like, yo, be careful with that, you know, that 50 dude. And I was like, what? I didn't know none of the history. And he was from Queens, so he knew. And I was just like, well, that has nothing to do with me. He's never going to say anything about me. None of that's, you know. And then I started hearing stuff, and I was like, what? And it's crazy because, like, the mentality is people look at you, if y'all together, they going after everybody. Nobody's, you know what I'm saying? Even innocent people. And that's just something I guess I just had to learn because I was like, "How? I don't have nothing to do with that. What are you talking about?" But we were all a team. We were winning. And, you know, I guess it comes with it.
Was that part of the reason why? Because you're not signed to Murder, Inc. no more, right?
No, not at all.
So was that part of that? Like, you was like, yo, I got to get away from this shit? Or?
No, it was... when all of that stuff happened, like with the indictment and all of that stuff, you saw me at the trial. I was there all the time. You know what I'm saying? Front row. And it got to the point where Murder, Inc. dissolved. You know what I'm saying? So what am I supposed to do? You know? So I got to the point where I had to create my own record label, get a distributor, and do what I do. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not, you're never going to put me in a situation where I'm going to be ass out. You know, if you throw me over the boat, it's going to be sink or swim. And I'm swimming. You know what I'm saying?
I'm the same way. And because I've never understood, but it was just too much going on. It was the case. It was the this, it was that. And to your credit, you kept it real. You was at all the... at the trial, you know, you're still brothers, but you was like, yo, I'm a female, by the way, too. Like, so,
I never
understood females being, like, collateral damage or being in the middle of a beef. Like, I felt like a female's a female, you know, it is what it is. Like,
exactly.
I've seen girls that are wives or like, damn with dudes I had beef with. And I never disrespected. Like, I always was like, actually, even weak, more respectful.
Only weak dudes do that. You know what I'm saying? And I've gotten apologies from them, more than one of them, over there, you know, on that team. You know what I'm saying? I've gotten apologies.
We'll switch it all the way positive, right? No, it's just, I feel like when I interview somebody, I want the people to learn something new about them.
Yeah.
So if they didn't know, with this coronavirus, you've been doing a lot for your community with the Beyond Beef and all that. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I mean, just being from Long Island, sometimes people forget about us. You know, people are overcome with Manhattan and Queens and the Bronx and all the boroughs. You know what I mean? And sometimes they forget about us all the way out here in Long Island. So I said, I want to do something. What can I do to help? You know, so I reached out to the Beyond Meat company. And it's funny because they had reached out to me a while ago, like last year when they first started the company, because I'm a pescatarian. I'm trying to go all the way, but I don't eat meat. So I've been on their products for a while. And I was like, I would love to be a part of this. I want you guys, can we help to donate to my local hospital where I was born? My mom used to work there. You know, my sister was born. Everybody in my family was born there. So we teamed up with them and we were able to get them free breakfast. And all the sandwiches were plant-based, which is cool because it gives you an option, you know? And they were like, thank you so much, because they appreciated everything, like food and drinks and stuff people were donating. But they were like, thank you for thinking about something healthy and thinking about something in the morning, because with our shifts, people at 6, 7, 8 in the morning, 5, 6, nothing is open. So they weren't able to enjoy the free donations. You know what I'm saying? So I was happy to be a part of it. We did the mask, too. We did the, I donated 30,000 N95 masks as well. So
that's beautiful, man. I can't even find one of the N95 masks. You donated 30. You know, I almost got killed in Africa because of you, right? Yeah. Yo, Shante, I almost got murdered in Africa.
We told y'all not to go to that part.
Yo, let me tell you, I went over there. They kidnapped me and John. But let me tell you the craziest shit that happened to me. One night, it was like 4 in the morning, and the door said, boom, 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 I'm in my boxes. So now we already shook, because this dude is like a warlord or whatever, right? I opened the door. He walks in and got 100 guys in the hallway with black suits on. So, you know, they talk Portuguese. They don't talk like... So he goes, pulls out a phone. He goes, Ashanti. I'm like, huh? He was like, Ashanti. So I'm like, yo, bro, I don't have Ashanti. He goes, what's love? What's love?
Oh, my God.
I'm looking at this dude, man. I'm looking at this dude. Thank you, mama. I'm looking at this dude, and he's like, Ashanti, give me the phone. I say, yo, bro, I just make music with her. I don't got her number. I can't get in touch with her. So he says, fuck Ashanti. Fuck Ashanti. I'm like, yo, this thing. He was looking forward to you coming out there. But he was trying to take it out on me.
Oh, and my God.
I said, oh, my God. And I remember when we got to Portugal. I got there. You came to that show. It was 3 shows in Africa and 1 in Portugal. And
yes.
You were there, glammed up, looking beautiful. Me and Ja been kidnapped for 2 weeks. In Angola, Africa, and you was like, yo, what's up, bro? I was like,
yo.
Like, yo, I'm your bro. You left me to die.
Yo, I don't know what part of the deal y'all was worked in. I don't know what happened with y'all part of the deal, but my part of the deal said Portugal, and that was it.
Yo, man.
Listen, I'm telling you, you know one of my attorneys, Steph. You know one of my attorneys.
Let me tell you something. I was like, yo, the dude was asking for Ashanti 4 in the morning. I remember I called Loretta. I was like, yo, man, This nigga tripping. He asking for a shanty now.
Yo!
And so, everybody gotta understand, if it's one thing, everybody know Fat Joe tough, he fight anybody. I'll fight him and them over there. They would've killed me. But we ain't got no guns. We over there, he got 100 dudes with him. And then they start, you know, this guy, right? And he never did nothing to me, but the United Nations came to see me. I'm in the lobby. So you gotta eat. You eat in the lobby. So a white dude and a black dude came and sat next to me. Yo, Fat Joe, what's up? I said, what's up? And they was like, yo, here's our card. This guy's a warlord. And if you're gonna, you might need this card to get out of here. Yo, it was that crazy, but
yo, I remember, and all I remember was when my attorneys and my accountant, when they had worked out the deal, they were like, I don't think they should go to that part. They was like, you're not going. My deal was structured for Portugal only, Joe, I promise.
Man, I always thought you left it. You didn't want to hear the shit Ja was saying. Ja was back here like, I'm like, yo,
both of y'all was cursing me out, and I didn't have nothing to do with it.
I'm happy you ain't come, to be honest with you. I'm happy you ain't come. You been watching these versus battles?
Yeah.
You saw the Jill Scott?
Definitely. I love the Jill Scott and Erica. One of my favorite parts of that, I came in the middle. One of my favorite parts was when Erica got cut off and Jill played Tyrone. And I was like, yo, she held her down. That's women empowerment right there. You know what I'm saying?
Now, that was super fly.
Yeah.
And from a woman empowerment perspective, there was no more beautiful moment than that. But from a guy perspective, I was like, Tyrone got that bitch back right now. Tyrone got tired of him. He got tired of every 2 o'clock in the morning, every station, every quiet storm station.
Oh,
this is not wrong. So you've been watching.
Mm-hmm.
Who would you pair up with? Who would Ashanti? What would be a good battle? Ashanti and who?
I don't know. Let the fans pick. I don't know. A couple of people have been hitting me and, you know, asking if I would do it. This one hair is just killing
me. Like other artists?
No, like some fans, some, you know, some people in my team, some people just, you know, regular people like, yo, who, same question. So I don't know.
I like Ashanti Keisha Cole.
Okay. Joe, stop calling me Ashanti. I know that's your accent.
Yo, damn, you know, Remy be killing me with that all the time.
Oh,
and my daughter, they say you always say that. So, what? How should I say it?
You say it good all the time. Sometimes you slip. It's a Shanti with an E.
You
like
I'm drinking all this Douce. I'm
see,
fucked up.
You doing the Douce and you saying a Shanti. You trying to rhyme and shit. You ain't got to do all that. Shanti.
Shanti, Keisha Cole. Would that be okay. A great one?
Listen, if they want to see it, I ain't mad.
Ooh.
No.
I love it. Like me personally, I wouldn't do it because I'm a bad loser and he's a worse winner. There won't be no woman empowerment. If the dude shit is off, I'll be like, yo, fuck him. He pussy. That's why the shit shut off. Like, I go back.
Yes, that's the problem. But I think, and I was saying that to a lot of people, but I think Jill and Erica showed how women could be empowered, how we could be positive and not catty and support each other. Because that's the thing. I was like, it's only dudes doing it because women are catty. You know what I'm saying? And you may say something and, you know, somebody may feel a way, you know? But they demonstrated pure class and just, it was an amazing experience. So maybe there's hope.
You heard it first on the Joker Show, the Fat Joke Show. Listen, sis, you know I love you. Don't worry about the one hair on the
this
side.
This one hair right here is killing me.
We
like,
can't see it.
Gosh. And my lighting was set up different. I ain't got no makeup on. Like, it's...
Tish, you look amazing. Oh. You got the song out with the little baby.
Oh, the baby. Yes.
The baby.
Yes.
That's fire.
Thank you, bro. You know I called you about that.
I know you called me. They don't know you called me about a lot of shit. Yeah, I'll tell you the truth. I'll tell you the truth. I'm like, get to the bag.
100%.
That's all everybody cares about, man. You got to get to the bag.
100%. Yeah,
so
the
you called me about that song.
It turned out to be something really dope because...
Can I talk about what you called me about or no?
Wait, which part? That? What else?
You called... Just that part. You called me and you said, yo.
Oh, yeah. I was like, yo, he's very vulgar.
And I was like, yo, sis, you're not the princess no more.